What's up, folks? Moon here. Today I'm just going to be doing some solo shuffle because I still don't have a consistent threes team yet. And, yeah, you get to see all the suffering that healers do firsthand. Alright, let's go ahead and queue into solo shuffle. 1694, tanked about 300 rating earlier today, as per usual with the Restoration Shaman experience. Okay, cool. You popped, let's go ahead and enter. Alrighty, we got ruins. Let's see what the lobby is. I sure hope it's not for melee. Well, okay. And we get to fight a Disc Priest too. Boy, Blizzard really is trying their best to make sure that I have the most fun possible. Let's see how the lobby's stacking up. Okay, cool. They put me in a 1400 lobby too, which... Oh boy. Yeah, so healer MMR, I know Blizzard really loves their healers, and they work to make sure that healers have the absolute most fun possible by making damage as miserable as possible to heal against. What do I even take here? Maybe precog? Maybe I try to bait out a kick? Maybe unleash? I'm not gonna have time to press really any buttons. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and open here. We're just gonna go ahead and try to yeet the rogue out of stealth. Unlikely that's gonna happen. But I'm gonna sit in Ghost Wolf. While that's happening, the rogue gets knocked out by the demon hunter. That's pretty good. Oh, and I'm lagging all over the place. Fantastic. I'm gonna go ahead and pre-earthen, but it's okay because my teammates decide to run out of it. Oh, and my UI glitches too. I'm having the best time of my life in solo shuffle. Oh boy. Ah, fuck. I can't. This game's unplayable. Cool. Fantastic. Glad to see that my game's running very well. It's running very smoothly. It's okay, guys. This is a tough round one. It's a tough round, you know. It's a little bit rough to heal into. But at least we have the Acid Rogue on our team. So we're just going to kite out this way. I have no idea why it did that. It's okay. You know, sometimes the game just sets you back 0-1 because it knows you're going to do well. Got to keep a positive mindset. I'm going to go ahead and double Earthen Wall. Swap the earth shield over to my warrior since he seems to be getting trained, lag a little bit more. All right, let's hope that that fixes up the lag some. I know my weak auras was going a little bit crazy there. Had another UI glitch, but you know, it happens. I did a quick little reload. Hopefully life will be good, you know. Hopefully my solo shuffle experience will improve. We did lose that one. I was doing, as you can see, about 50k HPS, but it doesn't matter because we still just die through anyways. Damage reduction is so much more invaluable. Or valuable, I should say. Pardon me. But it looks like a warrior's just going right in. I'm gonna go ahead and drop a fatty earthen down, followed by a healing stream totem, replenish this earth shield on him, and then I guess hot up my feral. I'm gonna swap over to my feral. Looks like he's gonna... Okay. Alright. Maybe my feral will press cooldowns. It's okay. It's okay, I have faith. Alright. Okay. Barkskin, little does he know he's gonna need... I'm... Okay. It's okay. You know, we're down three. We still have a chance to tie it. You know, I should have just trinket ascended Link. I should have just threw the whole sun at it. But it's okay. We can't get flamed. I ended up turning my chat off after getting in an altercation with another demon hunter who told me to kill myself when I was on a lockout. It's okay. You know, we just got to keep a positive mindset. At least that game was a little bit less laggy than the other two rounds. All right, so we're just going to go ahead and get ready for round four. You know, we gotta turn things around. It's gonna be our game. This is our lobby. We're gonna make the most of it. Cool, the rogue, he just wasn't in stealth. I mean, he was, but then he came out. I don't know exactly what got him out of stealth. I'm gonna pre-drop Healing Tide here because it's important to stay ahead of the damage, but it's okay because my Demon Hunter is gonna kite out of it. Don't worry, I'll just move him over to you. Yep, so you see, you gotta babysit players. They don't really know what they're doing. I'm gonna kick the healer here and then go for a hex. Alright, awesome. Maybe pre-tremor this incoming fear. Try and bait it from him too. Perfect, right into my tremor. The plan has been achieved. And I guess we could just sort of pool right here. I'm gonna go ahead and trade out Ascendance too for some extra fatty healing. I missed my kick. I'm gonna go for another hex. And then Lassa's warrior. Perfect. Wait, why did they swap on my hex? Oh, cool. Demon Hunter actually uses darkness. Yo. Guys, we may win a round. Let's go. Alrighty, we have two more in order for me to not lose anything else. Yeah, so that's the thing, guys, that you have to really keep in mind if you're gonna pick up healing, is that you just gotta turn chat off, because people don't have a brain at this Elo, and they actually don't even up and through 2.2k, so you're just gonna get used to getting flamed, or you're just gonna have to turn chat off. I have a really bad habit of yelling back at people because I need to let people know how stupid they are for trying to flame their healer over not pressing their cooldowns while I'm in a lockout. Especially while they have their cooldowns up too. I'm gonna go ahead and Earthen Wall into an Astral Shift. I think I really do need it. We have a lot of damage coming onto us, so it's imperative that we trade the appropriate amount of cooldowns to live this go. And as you can see, we just kind of hit the gritty right here. Drop Healing Tide. Okay, perfect. We're actually using cooldowns. I should have moved my totems over to me. Oh, but I get feared back into them anyways. It's fine. Yeah, so I could just kind of take this game a little bit more slow-paced. Somebody's going to get dropped eventually. I don't know when that's going to be, but it's going to happen, and boy, is it going to be random. Okay, cool. So it's okay. We've actually lost the round, which means no matter what the fuck happens next round, our CR will be going down. Go ahead and lasso this warrior here just to kind of alleviate some pressure, send him knockback, and slow him up. Oh jeez, I was hoping that druid didn't cast clone there. Perfect. All right, we got a full hex on that priest. This should be curtains. This should be, but it doesn't look. Oh, what are we? Okay, all right, it's okay. We use kidney shot on the priest instead of the kill target. I guess it's the new assassination meta. To just never kidney the actual kill target itself. It's okay. That was my bad. I didn't know. Alright, I'll go ahead and unleash shield just to kind of alleviate some of this pressure on us. There's my NS. That was my minute long heal. It did practically nothing. Alright, and then my thunderstorm also does nothing. Fantastic. Okay, cool. So I'm just kind of left in a position where I need to kite a little bit. Maybe get a riptide off here and there. Okay, cool. My healing tide came off of cooldown. I just hope that my rogue can live a little bit longer so that I don't lose too much CR with this. The warrior is just kind of beating on me. I can't really do anything. My BM falls in 1 second, so I'm gonna die. And we're in the execute spam range, so that's the unfortunate thing. The Pharaoh's health bar still just really isn't going down. I'm a little bit concerned. I'm just gonna get one tapped here. The warrior's hit 3-4 executes into me. Fantastic. I lose 62 rating. Yeah, that's basically the healer experience, guys. Whenever you're healing and you do a lot more than a priest, your team just, they forget how to do damage. And then when they're on the enemy team, you just kind of die through everything. Granted, I could have played that a lot better positionally. I was just trying to commentate and I was lagging for the first couple of games. But yeah, that's essentially the healer experience. Thanks everybody for watching. And I'll see you in the next video where I re-roll to something else.